Hello and greetings from Iceland. Today's update is about big news, and I will only be covering the volcano Askja now and doing another update on Saturday or Sunday covering the Reykjanes Peninsula, where things are also shaky, like all over Iceland actually. I'm sure that most of you already know what has been going on by Lake Askja recently, but if you're new to this, I'm linking to some of my more recent videos. And like I mentioned in my last update, the ice on the lake above the Askja caldera has been melting, and moreover, some of the snow around the lake has also been melting. So it's no question about it, the magma is getting closer. And then I found this interview yesterday, where one of our scientists stated that the magma intrusion that we already knew to be a big one has been estimated to be more than 10 cubic kilometers. So it's no wonder why our scientists have been letting this information out little by little.
Maybe if you tell me the bad news in a good way, it won't sound so bad to you.
And they say now that Askja will erupt. It's not about if, it's only a matter of time. So 10 cubic kilometers of magma, what does that mean? So let's move a bit further south from the Askja Lake to this lava field from 2014. And this lava field called Holuhraun, it is Iceland's hotspot, Bárðarbunga, that's responsible for this. All the lava under there didn't make it through the ice cap on top of the caldera, so it found its way through a magma dike and came up 40 kilometers away from the glacier. And back then it was all over the news how enormous amount of lava came up there. That covers an area of 85 square kilometers. And the third and last sample is the famous Lake eruption. It covered 600 square kilometers, and that was in 1783. So when I got this number, 10 cubic kilometers or more, it's not far away from the Lake eruption. And I have actually no clue about what kind of eruption to expect up by Lake Askja. But what we know for sure is that the amount of magma that is estimated to be there now seems to be enough to create one of the largest lava fields on Earth. And that is one of the things that defines Iceland, or the extreme amount of lava that we get. And Iceland is of course just a big chunk of lava. Luckily, however, this takes place up on the highlands. For sure, one of the best places to get such a large eruption as we could get. And the location is, of course, a very important factor, or how lucky or unlucky we get. So when we look at this from this angle, we have been seeing many earthquakes by Mount Herðubreið recently. Like this morning, we got a magnitude 3.5 there, or on the fissure swarm from the Askja volcano. So I don't see it as an unlikely scenario if we would get a fissure eruption to the north or northeast. But we do have a problem there, or a glacier river. That's where the lava would flow. And if this glacial river were to be blocked for days or weeks, it's a recipe for a disaster, similar to the disaster that caused the formation of Ásbyrgi. However, in that case, it's believed that it was an ice dam on the glacier that caused all that. So like often before, this new statement is leaving me with more questions than answers. And the Askja volcano is perhaps our strangest volcanic system. At least you can say it's totally unpredictable. And so far my main concern has been what if the magma chamber that's under this lake comes in contact with the water that's already warming up, or how big could the explosion get? And one of the reasons I'm asking is that I'm less than 100 kilometers away, but it's only now that we are learning how extremely large this magma intrusion is. And again, the reporter just handled this comment just as anyday news. So now is the time to recommend a good book for you, extremely valuable source of information, written by perhaps the first proper travel vlogger in Iceland, William Lord Watts, who walked across Vatnajökull Glacier in 1876. And he was one of the few people who actually saw Askja after the main eruption in 1875, and he also got to see the beginning of the so-called Mývatn fires that started shortly after the Askja eruption, a bit further north on the plate boundaries. And there are many who say that this book is perhaps the most reliable source about the Askja eruption back then, and how the land looked before the lake emerged on top of the caldera. And speaking of how reliable this book looks to me, Mr. Watts is describing the old Icelandic food as horribly disgusting, so I can confirm that he was very honest, and we Icelanders do therefore believe that the rest of his reports were just as accurate. But I browsed through it just recently to get some tips for a longer video about this huge phenomenon on the highlands, and this video leaves plenty of room for speculations in the comment section. Or what will Mother Earth do with those 10 cubic kilometers of magma? And the short version is that this can go two ways, or a traditional eruption, fissure eruption, and then it's the explosive type, blowing up the lake in a plume of ash and steam, 20-30 kilometers. And eruption of that kind would most likely be over quite fast, but if it's going to be a fissure eruption, I would be looking at the area between Mount Herðubreið and Lake Askja. And that option looks in a way more appealing to me than to see the whole lake blow up in smoke and steam. But the thing is that an eruption seems inevitable now. We are in for a major event. So while I was making notes for this video, I decided to pull some strings and go get a cup of coffee with an old pilot that lives nearby. I have actually asked him this favor before, or to plug me to some of the local guys with small planes. And my original plan was to go up there after an eruption would start there. But it's very likely that there would be a flight ban there for some time, leaving me with no footage. And then I was watching the news yesterday, or this geologist over Lake Askja with a horrible camera, not even a proper zoom lens. So I thought, yeah, I will have to do this myself. I have a good zoom lens, so the idea that's bugging me now is to fly over there, do the wide shots, medium shots, and of course the zoom shots, the whole package, since there seems to be a new story from up there every day now, and I might just be the last man to get this landscape on film. And just now when I was finishing the voiceover, I got the news that the experts say that there is some steam coming up from a lake. So you can just imagine how I feel now, or the trigger finger. It's itchy. I want photos. So I will be using the good old buddy method. Go visit the pilot and see if he knows anyone crazy enough to fly me up there. I have to get photos from there. But the dream project was of course to bring a thermal drone up there. But it's not a wise thing to do now. Not even our scientists dare to go there. They just dropped some thermometers into the lake from a plane and took off home fast. So there is still a reason to remind you about the drone fund. And again, I'm sending those of you who have been helping me out my sincere thanks. This is all moving into the right direction, but it's a big investment for a small channel. And as far as I know, thermal drones have not been used so much to detect abnormalities on the surface. And my goal is of course to keep you updated and provide footage that you won't get elsewhere. So this drone is still on my priority list, and you will understand the reason even better after my next video, where I will be covering the most recent news from the Reykjanes Peninsula, where things are also shaking. And scientists do not completely agree on how that could develop or how fast. So I have a fine story there. And I will cover both sides, of course. But overall, here in Iceland, you can just check the live feed from the seismometers. We see increased seismic unrest all around. And I'm not sure if this is going to end up with an eruption just now, but it would not surprise me though. And I have the feeling that Askja will be the next to erupt, like I mentioned in my forecast for 2023. And it's gonna be days or weeks rather than months. And we have to keep in mind that this trend up there started in 2012. This is nothing new. And no matter what kind of eruption it will be, it is quite clear that the landscape there will change forever. And the lake could just as well be gone tomorrow. Iceland's second deepest lake. So, once again, Mother Nature is taking action to recreate Iceland. Here on the plate boundaries in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the Volcano Island, Iceland.